AI is the solution for everything. Well, when you see the exploding number of new AI-driven applications emerging daily, it might certainly seem so. But let's dive into what AI can and what AI can't do, what problems it can solve in your organization, or what new experiences and services it can create. Today, we delve into the heart of AI's potential with two leading experts, Vicky Bunyard, CTO for IBM Technology for Northern, Central and Eastern Europe, and Sophie Kuijt, Distinguished Engineer and CTO for IBM Consulting, Northern, Central and Eastern Europe. Welcome.
Thank you, Ronald.
So, Sophie, you have an extensive experience in AI implementations. Could you share some examples where AI significantly solved a complex problem and also transformed the scenario?
Yes, so indeed. So AI technology, and especially the generative AI at the moment, it can be both a problem solver, but it is also many times an opportunity for generating complete new value. And I think we see use cases popping up in all areas. One example when you look at problem solvers is, for example, for in application modernization and a generation of, for example, personas when you're working on your design cases, is something where generative AI can really help you to create personas for your design cases. It can do that in a very speedy way, and that is something that our designers are really now welcoming a lot in the way how they do their job. And I see that also at the organizations we work with. Same goes, for example, for testers who need to create test scenarios and are really helped now by the technology to create test scenarios in a very quick way and using the automation capability that comes with that. If you look at how it can generate new opportunities, now that is when you look at, for example, organizations that have a large sets or have large sets of data that they can now leverage for new purposes. An example of that is as IBM, we work together with NASA. And NASA is having large sets of data, of geospatial data of Earth. And that is something they really want to leverage also for new cases. And that's where IBM started a partnership with them. And that is now generated in a lot of open source new foundational models that can be used for that data for also by the public. And it can be used for research and also for the literature that is collected around it to really search in an easy way, but also to really track and that on a longer piece of time to do research on it, to really do climate research. And I think that's a good example of an organization who has a lot of data and can now, with the AI technology available, make that available also for the larger public in a very consumable way.
Yeah, I like this new type of cases, new innovation. So Vicky, as a more tech expert, how do you view AI role in creating new opportunities, and particularly then in the field for maybe traditional non-AI driven organizations and fields for both both different type of perspectives? So can you give some examples of this?
I think then it becomes a case of, you know, for your company, for your organization, what are those insights that are going to have the most impact for you? So is it about how customers are behaving? Is it about how, I don't know, if you're in a government organization, how your citizens are behaving? Can you offer or do things in a different way to support your citizens or your customers? And so I think there's one dimension, which is really getting to that those insights and that promise that we've always had of, you know, being data driven and understanding what's coming through our data. And then I think the other dimension of it is really around, how do I use the AI to enable my interactions more effectively, to whether that's with my employees, whether it's with my customers, whether it's with my citizens, whether it's with my, you know, whatever my user base may be. And so I think key in there is there's so much that we can do around that. And the real question is, what for your organization is going to make the difference right now? Is it a more interactive way of working with your customers, or is it more insight from the data that you have and how you're operating, for example?
Now, how can businesses or even individuals, how can they prepare for this? And let's start with you, Sophie. Can you give some examples or maybe even steps how they can prepare?
Yes. So the beauty of this technology is that you can start really small, think about things, experiment with things, and then later on scale this. So this doesn't require a lengthy preparation in that sense. However, it is important that you really follow a process designed for AI. And in that, you clearly think about what is the intent, what I like to solve, or what is the new value I would like to create. That you really think about what is the data, what I need, what is it, and what am I going to use? Is it already available? Do I need something still to do with it, to collect it, or to apply it in a proper way? And then also follow that through in the life cycle, that you design immediately with also in mind that you need to govern this technology at a certain point, because developing is one part. But with AI technology, you must prepare that you will always there will always be a need to monitor and govern this technology in a good way. You should see it like, yeah, it's really one element that you launch it and then you keep on tracking it. And that is important because of compliance to the current regulations, which are already there, GDPR, and also the upcoming AI Act. It demands that you are looking after the technology that you create specifically in this field.
And you're addressing a couple of interesting points. You say you can start small, but then you need to scale and you need to be sure that you have a proper governance. Now, Vicky, if we look to this, especially the scaling and the governance, if you start small, do you need a proper foundation and then you can scale? Or do you see mistakes in the market that people start small and then they cannot scale anymore because they don't have the foundation and they cannot have their governance in place because of this?
Yeah, and I think there's a few dimensions to this, but you mentioned the models, and I think there is a real acceleration factor that you can get. And certainly the capabilities that we're putting out there include, for example, domain-specific models, which allow you to get running much more quickly. So to Sophie's point about, you know, get moving quickly and use some of the existing models that we have to really get that acceleration, but also, you know, having the ability to then tailor those models to your specific organization or your specific industry is important. And also then as you become more confident and more competent, having the ability to then build your own models is really powerful. But then, you know, coming back to this idea of starting with the end in mind, for example. So starting from the perspective that you know you might be building something small, but ultimately you want to be able to put this into production in your enterprise. And if you're going to do that, you need to have the right governance in place. You need to have the right data governance in place, but also the right AI governance so that you understand how your model is operating, what training data you've got, and what, you know, what outcomes you're getting from the perspective of govern data, govern models, and then being able to get to the right trust and transparency, and ultimately then being able to be compliant to the regulations that Sophie already mentioned. So for example, the EU AI Act. So fundamentalists start with the end in mind, use the models that are available, the focused domain-specific models that allow you to get running really quickly, and then have the platform in place that allows you to do that in a way that is governed and controlled and transparent and trusted. And that will allow you then to accelerate that whole process and get out there and get into production and get into your enterprise so that you get to that value much more quickly.
And I still see many organizations, they start small, but they forget about the proper foundation and the proper governance to scale it in the end. So it's a spot on topic. Thank you, Sophie. Thank you, Vicky. Great insights, great strategies. And for our audience, thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time.